So far we have completed working with styles templates, right? So now today we are going to see your session 4. We have already completed these, that is applying styles. Session 1 was applying styles, session 2 was inserting and using images in a document, and session 3 was creating and using a template. So we will be now seeing creating and customizing tables of contents. So let me share the screen first. So create and customize table of content. So this is what we are going to discuss today. That is session 4 in your chapter digital documentation, and we will be seeing this in all the 3 softwares, right? So first of all, what are table of content? By the end of this video, you will be able to learn hierarchy of headings, customizing a table of content, apply character styles, choosing paragraph styles for heading levels, and so on. I want a quick feedback from everyone. Are you all able to hear me properly? I'm going to allow the mic. Just give me a quick feedback. Are you able to hear me and see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, fine. Ma'am. Okay, good. So, okay, that's good. So I'm disabling the mics. As I already, like I said, I will be giving you 10 minutes at the end of the lesson. And at that time, you can ask me all your doubts. Okay. So these are the things which we are going to learn for LibreOffice. And more or less the same things we will learn for OpenOffice as well as Word. Now, first of all, for this purposes, now what is table of content? You might have seen when you read a book, there is a table of content in the beginning, which shows the serial number, that is the chapter number, the chapter name, and then also you get along with this the chapter, you get the chapter name, and then the page number is also specified. Okay, any kind of table of content which you see, if I have to show you a table of content, just give me a moment, I will show it to you. For example, there is an ebook with me over here. Now you can see something here. You can see working with functions. Okay. This is all. Now this is a part of a larger table of content. Got it? So its serial number is what? Its chapter number is 3. Then within that you have subheadings, subheadings, and you can see the level. This is 3. 3.1, 3.2, and because this calling invoking function, this is a subheading within this subheading, so it is taking 3.2, 0.1, 3.2, 0.2, okay, and this way it goes on. And you can also see the page number in front of it, which page number it belongs to, right? Let me show you one more example. Like over here, you can see a simple content page. Serial number, name of the unit, page number. Okay, so this is the basic and very simple type of a table of content, which you will find in the beginning of every book. Okay, so I'm just showing you these examples over here so that you get an idea about what is table of content. Like you can see it over here also, another example, unit 1, communication skills, which page number, this is the page number, and within that subheadings are there, session 1, session 2, and so on, and their page numbers are also provided over here. So now in these table of content, you need to first, before you create a table of content, you need to understand hierarchy of headings. Let us go back to styles. When we studied styles, We had studied that there are various types of paragraph styles, okay, and within that we had a style named heading style. If I tell you about this, this is the styles tab which you can see here, okay, and within this styles tab you can see the heading levels. There are 10 heading levels which are given, heading 1 to heading 10, where heading 1 is the largest size and heading 10 is the smallest size. Got it? So now what I need to do over here is I have to create a hierarchy of headings. To create a table of content for a document, the writer application will read through the headings that are part of the document and can create the table of content from this. So it is very important that we first create a hierarchy of headings. We first create headings because it is from these 10 heading levels only that your table of content is created. You can change the headings, the table of contents will be automatically updated. Writer's table of content features lets you build an automated table of content from the headings in the document. If you have headings in the document or text in the document which are styled as headings, okay, whether it's heading level 1 or heading level 10. So writer's table of content feature automatically creates table of content using those headings. Whenever changes are made to the text of a heading in the body of the document, so if you make any changes to any of the headings, you can easily update your table of content. How to do it? Let's see. This is a chapter. This is a document which I created, and you can see the name of this document, Language and Literature Text. Okay. So this is a document which I created, and what I want is I want to create a kind of a number of, it's like a book which I'm writing, okay, and which contains a number of chapters. So you can see over here, chapter one is how I taught my grandmother to read. This is the first chapter. Then I have chapter two over here, a dog named Duke. Then I come down again. I have chapter 3, The Man Who Knew Too Much. I think you people have already studied this because it is 9th class language and literature textbook ebook, which I have downloaded from NCERT website. Then chapter 4. So what I want is I want a table of content. As you can see that the number of pages in this document are 7 pages. Okay. So what I want is right in the beginning, I want a table of content. I want an index. Okay, so for that, I need to first select all these headings. Okay, and style them, apply the heading style on them. So because I want the first heading level will be heading 1. So I will be first styling this heading using what? Heading 1. So you can see the styles panel is open over here, and within that I have already selected the paragraph styles tab, and within that you can see you will be finding this kind of a label named heading, and beside that, just in front of that, there is a plus sign showing that it can be expanded. If you expand it, you will find a number of headings. So you'd only need to pay attention to heading 1 through heading 10. Okay. Now the first heading, like chapter 1, it should always take up heading 1. Subheading can take up heading 2. Subheading can take up heading 3, and so on and so forth. So I've selected this chapter 1, how I taught my grandmother to read, which will be my heading level 1, and I am going to double click heading 1 over here so that this heading level 1 gets applied to this. Now I am going to scroll down, and I am going to also select chapter 2, also give it heading 1, Then I'm going to again scroll down. Chapter 3. Again format that. Come down. Chapter 4. And also give it heading 1. Now there were only 4 chapters which I had in my document. So that's all. Save it using Control S. Now scroll to the top of the page. Place your cursor right before this chapter 1. Press enter. Place your cursor over here in an empty region on an empty line above all chapters. So you created a hierarchy of heading containing only first level heading, that is heading 1. Now what we are going to do, please pay close attention. We are going to go to the insert tab, insert menu over here, okay? Within the insert menu, scroll down and you'll come to this option here, table of contents and index. Within that, select the first option here, that is table of contents, index or bibliography. I'll again go back, we go to index, table of contents and index, table of contents, index or bibliography. Click on that and you get this dialog box in front of you. What is this dialog box? Table of contents, index or bibliography, and make sure that type page is opened over here. Now it might be appearing kind of very complicated, so you don't have to worry about it. Only pay attention to certain areas. You don't need to worry about all the options being displayed here. Title, you can change the title and you can write index over here. Okay. Or my table of content. And you can see over here that in the preview box that as you are making changes here, those changes are getting reflected in the preview box. So this preview box is going to show you a preview of what will appear in your document. So you can see here heading 1, heading 1.1, entry, heading 1.2 and so on, right? So heading 1, this is the content from the first chapter, right? Then this is the content from chapter 1.1. This is the content from chapter 1.2. So this is done. Now what we can do is simply click on OK. And you can see automatically your table of content is created containing how many chapters? 4 chapters. These 4 chapters are actually 4 heads, 4 headings. Each of them is formatted using heading level 1. Okay, so it is very important. Now this table of content doesn't work on normal text. It works only on heading level, heading text. So you have to first select that particular text which you want in your index. You have to first select it, apply which style on it, the paragraph style named heading 1 on it. Then only you will be able to convert it into my table of content. Now this table of content is so flexible that if you make any changes here, like how I taught my grandmother, suppose I'm removing this to read. And you can see over here it is only to read. So just right click on your table of content and click on this option, update index. You will see that to read is gone from here. That. So you make any changes in your table of content. If I just write here, I just made some changes. Okay. Now right click here, update index, and it makes changes over here. So you can easily make the changes. If there is some change in the heading, make those changes and right click on your table of content and just select update index. So it will update everything. You add any text and it goes to the next page. Right. You add any text and it goes to the next page. Automatically the page number will also get updated over here. Understood this? So this is how you can create a basic table of content. Now what we need to do is, I'm going to again reset it back to read and a dog named Duke. Okay. And go back to the table of content, right click, update index, and it is again updated. Right. Now, what we need to do is, okay, I'm going to unmute everyone to take a quick feedback. Okay, students, tell me, did you understand this part? How to create a basic table of content, how to first set the chapter name as heading level one, and then create the table of content and automatically updating the table of content also. Is this clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yes. Yes, Devyansh.
Ma'am, around 9 o'clock, I hang up and rejoin again due to network issue.
Okay, good. These days we have a feature in attendance that is it shows the total amount of time. Even if you hang up and rejoin, it will show two records. So by adding up the time, I can figure out how much time you were logged in. If somebody logs in for less than 10 minutes, okay, that means not less than 10 minutes. Somebody logs in for less than the amount of time, that is at least 40 minutes, you should log in. So if you have logged in for less than 40 minutes, or let me consider less than half an hour, then your record will be deleted. Your attendance will not be taken. So you have to make sure that you complete your login time. Okay, that is most important. So I hope it was clear to all of you. This much was clear. Now we will move forward with the next part. Okay. Now, next, what we need to do is, now, as we already saw in the previous screenshots of various ebooks which I showed you, we don't just have the one heading level. We have multiple levels. Like this is the second level of heading. Okay. And in that previous 12th class book, we had three levels of heading. Level 1, level 2, level 3. So now what I want is a level 2 heading. So what about level 2 heading? You can see over here, within every chapter, you have an information about the author. About the author info is given everywhere. So what I want is, I will first select this about the author and style it with heading level 2. You can see it over here. This is heading level 2. Coming down, again this one, heading level 2. Again coming down. And then we have the last one. Got it? Now we got our second heading level. Now right click on it. Update index, and you can see that the second heading level is also added over here. Right click again, click on edit index, and here you can see that we have two heading levels, heading 1 and heading 1.1. Okay, just a sec. Okay, I want to also add this chapter. Okay, doesn't matter. So this was heading level 2. Okay, coming down, we also have at the end of every chapter questions based on text. So I'm going to set this as heading 3. Same way for the other also. So this way I'm going to set it for all, right? go back, right click on it, update index, and you can see that there are how many levels now? There are three levels. This is first level, which has no indentation. Then second level, which is indented a little bit. And then you have the third level. So level one, level two, level three. If you want to make additional changes into it, right click on it and go to edit index. Now here you can see there is a second tab, second page over here named as entries. So when you go to entries here, you see all the 10 levels of heading. Okay. You can have up to 10 levels of heading. Beyond having levels beyond that doesn't make sense. So up to 10 levels of heading you have. Right now, level one is selected. That is, whatever changes you make, it will be made on level one of headings only, right? That is, in our case, all the chapter names. So what all changes can be made? Like, for example, the first one is hyperlink start. Now, hyperlink start is for what? If you want that, I'm just clicking on OK here. Sometimes I want that if I click on the first one, it should take me whichever text I click on, it should take me to that text. Like, for example, I want to reach to chapter 3, The Man Who Knew Too Much. So you can see as I am placing my cursor on top, it is giving me a tooltip. What is the tooltip? Control click to open hyperlink. So how will I do this? So I'll press control button on my keyboard and click on this text. So you reach that third page. Not third page, beginning of chapter 3. Okay, again you go to the top. I want to go to questions based on text for chapter 4. Okay, keep the control key pressed and click on this. You reach questions based on text for chapter 4, right? So this is how you can easily link the text along with your table of content also. So right click on it and select edit index. I'm going to again show it to you in magnified view. Right click, edit index. So the first one over here is hyperlink start. If you want, you can also edit it. You can also give any kind of paragraph style to it, any kind of character style to it. So I'll create a custom character style in my document first. So how do I create a style? Again, a quick recap of that. So first of all, I will go to the styles box over here, styles pane. Select character styles from here, right? And make sure that default character style is selected. Now I will select any one character from anywhere within my text. Make sure not from within the headings, okay? From within the normal text. So I have selected capital N over here. Now I'll just go to this drop-down box and select some specific type of a font, whichever we need. So I want to select this one, Franklin Gothic Demi Condensed. Okay, so I've selected this and you can see it takes up this font. Font size, let it be like that only. Font color I can change. So suppose the font color which I want is green color. So you can see green color over here. I'll take a bright color. I'll take red color, okay? So that it is clear to you. So I have taken this. Now I'll go back to the styles pane, click on style actions, select new style from selection, give it a name, my care style. Remember this now, my care style is the new type of character style which I created. Click on OK. And this style gets added to this list. Now this is the style which I am going to add to my table of content also. So right click on the table of content, go to edit index. Make sure entries is selected, level one is selected. And now over here, what I'm going to do is, I have selected hyperlink start, that is index link, character style. So drop down, it will show all the character styles which are there in your document. And you can see this one, my cat style. Click on this and you can see that this heading one changes. Okay. When you click on OK, you'll be able to see that it is applied on the entire table of content. Right? Right click again. Let us try to change some other features like chapter number. So I'll click on this chapter number. You can see automatically character style comes up. So I'll click on this. Maybe I'll select something else. Let me create two, three different types of character styles, okay? So I'm going to select capital A and I'll be giving it some other color, maybe a purple color, I'll give it, okay? Please just give me a moment, I'm getting a call. Sorry for the interruption. There was a call from a student, so I disconnected the call. Okay, so now I have selected this and I want to set a new character style. So I'll go to this style actions. New style from selection. Let me give char style L2. Okay, second level. Click on OK and that level 2 style is created. And one more I'll create for level 3. Let me select green color and I'm going to select another font, Adobe Caslon, and go to this. Just give it a name, L3. Click on OK and three different character styles you can see in this box. One is my char style, one is char style 2, and one is char style 3, right? Okay. Now I'll go back to my content, right click, edit index. Okay. So we have chapter number here, so I'm selecting this chapter number. Which character style do I want? So I will select the first one. Maybe I can select some other one, that is rubies. Okay. Format. Number without separator. You can also make changes to this. So I'll go to edit and maybe I can give some other font color to it. Suppose I give it a blue colored font. Okay, click on OK. So I'm not getting this chapter number anywhere. Okay, I'll work on that. We'll see when we can get it right. So I'll just leave it at that. We come to the next one, that is entry. Now, what is the entry one? So for entry, now let me give any other character style. You can see that character style level 2, level 3 is appearing here. Okay. And my character style is also there, which is already applied for entry. So if I click on that, click on OK. Not much change you will find over here. Fine. We go back again. We go to the next one, that is tab stop. Now, what is tab stop? These dots which you see, they are tab stop. So they can be changed. Like I can give any other character style to it. For example, I'll click on caption characters, right? Go to edit. Give a font color. Suppose I give this brick font color to it. Click on OK. So this is the brick font color. I'll click on apply, click on OK. And this fill is dot, so I can change the fill to dash. So you can see it takes up dash. Click on OK and you can see how it changes. This leader line, which you can see, this dotted line, which you can see, that is for tabs. And you can see slight difference in the color also. I can show it to you by changing the color a little bit more. Like I had selected brick, so I will select some other color, maybe light purple. click on apply, click on OK, click on OK, and now you can see light purple color over here. Okay, so that is tab. Right click again, go to index. Now we have page number. You can also change the color of the page number. So click on this page number, character style. Go for the first one, that is my character style. So click on my character style only. In the preview box, you can see the style of page numbers changing. Click on OK and you can see it changes. Now it is making changes only for level 1 heading. Coming to level 2 heading, right click, edit index. We need to first select 2 from here in level box, okay? And then I can make multiple changes over here. Like I can go to hyperlink, okay? I can change it. I can go to, you know, you need not change all of them. If you want to change only the style of page number, you can do that. Like I'm only selecting page number here, okay? And from here, I'm going to select char style level 2, which I created earlier, right? Click on OK and you can see that level 2 has been added. It's also, it was a purple color which I had selected. So it is taking up purple color. Right click, update index. I'm selecting level 3 now, page number, and I'm going to select char style level 3. And level 3 was green color. So you can see that green color over here, right? Right click. For level 3, I want to change the tab stop. So I'll click on this tab stop. I'll change the fill character to long dash. Okay. And let me set the character style as level 3 only. Click on OK. And you can see it takes up long dash. Okay. And it takes up the same color as given to the style. If you want, you can make that change also. So we go to level 3. We select tab stop, okay, we go to edit. And from here, you can select some other color like yellow color. Click on OK. And you can see it takes up yellow color. So you can make that change over here also. And because you made changes to style 3, so that style 3 has also changed over here, right? So this is how you can make changes. Just a sec. I'm trying to get this chapter number. I'm not getting that. Okay, doesn't matter. I'll work on that and later on I'll let you know. One more thing I'll tell you in this, that is styles. Now, level 1 takes up content 1. Okay, if I want, I can change that style. Like I can select, it will show only paragraph styles from here. So right now it has taken up content 1 style. So if I'm going to change it, like I can change it to any other style, although this is not that needed, but you can still change it. Like I'm selecting this heading 1 and I want to set that heading 1 as content 1. So I'll just have to click on this heading, content 1, and like this, and you can see that heading 1 changes. Okay. So although we don't need it much, you can reset it back by selecting content 1 or click on default, right? So content 1 and this, and it is done. So we don't need to make any changes here. The next one I'll tell you, columns. Now right now what you can see in this is that everything is appearing as one single column only. Suppose there is a very long table of content and you want to reduce the amount of space. Lot of space is being occupied by these dashes and dots. So what I want is two chapter names should be displayed on the left hand side and two chapter names on the right hand side. So for that, right click, go to edit index, columns, okay, is there. Select two columns from here. Click on OK and you can see it is divided into two columns. Although it doesn't look very nice on a table of content, so you can reset it back by going to edit index and again selecting single column. Last option which I'm going to tell you is go to edit index. And in the background here, you can see a dull gray color. Okay, so instead of that, you can set any color. Like go to color. I want, suppose, light gold one. So I've selected that. Click on OK. And you get a light gold color in the background. Again, right click, edit index. If you don't want any color, just click on none. Click on OK. Okay. So it will still give you this background color. So right click, edit index, go to color and select white color. I'm not getting that white color. Yes, so now I got white color over there. So now it is almost looking as if the background is transparent. You can set any color. There will always be some color in the background. Okay, like this is teal, so I gave this color. Next is bitmap. If you don't want any color and you instead you want any image in the background, you can do that. So click on bitmap and you will find some images over here, some bitmap images over here. Suppose I like this pool texture very much, so I have selected that. Click on OK and you'll get this pool texture in the background. Click on edit. You can also set its transparency from here. Let me see if I can set its transparency. No, cannot. Anyways, doesn't matter. I'll select some other like surface and it is kind of neat and it looks good. Okay. And if you want, you can also give a custom image in its background. So for that, you'll go to background, bitmap, and you'll go to add import. Now from here, let me select any nice image for the background. Let me see if I get some nice images. No, I don't have it here. I have some custom backgrounds here, like I want this background. So I've selected it. Click on open and click on OK. And that background is added over here. So you can also provide your own custom background to your table of content. I'm unmuting. Any doubts, please ask me. Chapter number, of course, I'm going to work on that and see how we can get the chapter number, because I tried some options. I'm not getting that chapter number here. So I give one. Any doubts, please ask me, students, while I'm trying this out. Now, I got this chapter number, but this is the number which is being typed by me. So that is why I don't consider it as that. If I can No, I'm not getting that. Doesn't matter. We'll see it later. Okay. Anyway, so any doubt in this, students? Basic how to create a hierarchy of headings and how to insert a table of content. How to update it, making changes and updating. And also to edit it, making other settings. Is that much clear to everyone? Any doubt, please ask me so that we can move ahead. You can raise your hand if you have any doubt. Yes, Esmudit Kumar.
Ma'am, no doubt.
No doubt, it was clear. Yes, of course, I'll be giving you all the recorded session also, so you can do your practicals. So that was for LibreOffice Writer. Okay, this whole thing. Now the same thing we will be doing in your OpenOffice Writer also, right? So I'm going to save this document over here, that is Language and Literature, and I'm going to copy this text till the end. And I will be closing it from here. Okay, let's see. Apply character styles, we did all that. And now we will be seeing this in Apache OpenOffice Writer. So again, all these things we will be seeing in that. So I go to my start and open Apache OpenOffice. So this is Apache OpenOffice. We have opened it. I'm going to click on text document. And here I'm going to simply paste it in an unformatted way. So look very carefully. I'll go to edit and I'll go to paste special. You have two options, paste and paste special. Difference between the two is if you just want to paste the copied text as it is, as it was given in the original document, in the source document, with all its formatting, everything, then you choose paste. But if you want to only paste the text, not its format, then select paste special. And from here, you select this last option, that is unformatted text. Click on OK. And this whole thing gets pasted over here. Right? I'm going to first save this document. So I pressed Control S and I'm going to save it as English Literature Literary Reader. Okay. So I've just given a name to it and click on Save, right? So it takes up some moment to save it. Now my document is saved. Fine. Now what to do? I need to now first create the hierarchy of headings again. So we'll go to the right hand side panel over here, the sidebar, and select this option, styles and formatting. Option which we need to select, styles and formatting. So we get the styles and formatting box over here, side panel, and you can see all the 10 heading levels, heading 1, heading 2, till heading 10. Now here heading 10 is displayed over here right below 1, because here heading 1, heading 10, heading 2, this 1, 2, 3 is being identified as text and not as number. So when it is when 1, 2, 3, 4 is identified as text, that is string, so there it will take up the alphabetical order. So because 1 and 1, they are at the same level, then 1, 0, so it will be displaying it like this. But there are 10 heading levels over here. So for the first one, I'm going to select this text and apply what? Heading 1. Same way, I'm going to go to the next one also. Heading 2. Okay. Coming down. Chapter 3, That will be heading 3. Go to chapter 4. And one second, I think I did something wrong, very wrong. Chapter 2 will be heading 1. Chapter 3 will be heading 1. Yes, I was going with the flow, so 1, 2, 3. It was like that. All of them have to be heading 1. Okay. Now go back to the top. Just click before 1. Press enter and place your cursor right over here. Now, watch very carefully. We need to go to which menu? Insert menu. And just scroll down and here you will find an option. Can you guess the option over here? It is indexes and tables. Okay. There it was a long text written, right? So here it is indexes and tables. And indexes and tables. So we'll click on this. And you get this insert index or table dialog box where you can see the preview box over here, right? And table of contents, you can change this title to anything which you like. You can make it table of contents, my table of contents, index, my custom index, anything, whatever you want, right? And click on OK. So you get this table of contents, which is automatically inserted. Rest of the procedure is same as LibreOffice only, but I will still repeat it. So it will be a kind of revision for you. If I make any changes here, how I taught my grandmother, instead of that, I'm just writing here how I taught my grandfather to read. Make all the changes wherever you want. A dog named Lucas. And maybe a man who didn't know much. This is the change which I am making. Okay, so I made some changes. Now I'll go back to the top, right click, and select what? Update index or table. So you can see all the changes are applied over here. Got it? I'll press Ctrl Z because I don't want to disturb the name of the chapters. Okay, not taking up, doesn't matter. I'll make the changes. This was grandmother, dog named Duke, a man who knew too much. These are the changes I made again. We'll go back to the top, right click, update index. So it is updated. Now, coming to the second level. About the author, I'm going to select that and give it heading 2. Come down, about the author, heading 2. Here also heading 2. So made the changes, right? Go back to the top, right click, update index, and you can see that second level heads are also added here. And same way with the third level head. Select it, give it which level? Heading 3. Again, heading 3. Again, heading 3. And here also, heading 3. Got it? Go back to the top, right click, update. So you can see that it is easily updated, all the chapters. So the process is more or less the same. Let us try creating some new styles. So I'll be creating 3 different character styles now. So for creating character styles, first of all, I'll have to go to which option? Character styles. And here I will try to create at least 3 different levels of character styles. So watch very carefully. I've selected N. And let me give it trebuchet, bold, and italic. Okay, and I will be giving it a color, a font color that is red. Fine. This is first style, first character style. So I have to make sure that this text is selected. Now I'll go to styles and formatting, new style from selection, new style, and give it 1 or CAD style level 1. L1 shows 1. Click on OK. And CAD style L1 is added over here. Same way, I'm selecting another character and I'm going to give it some other font. Adobe Caslon Pro, bold, and text style, I will change to blue. Go back to this new style from selection. Take the name and set it as L2, level 2. Okay, so level 2 is created over here. Take a third one. Give it some other font, maybe this one, and bold, and font color, I can give it as green. New style from selection, L3, click on OK. And three different styles are created, as you can see over here in the list. Okay, now you can reset these back again, right? Because the styles are already there. So at the end of everything, we will reset it back. So now we come back over here, right click, go to edit index or table. Now we go to entries. Here again, you can see 10 different levels. I want to make some changes in the entries. So first of all, I'll be selecting chapter number. Same problem with the chapter number is also there. It's not getting displayed. So we'll see what can be done for that. So character style, I'm selecting as CAD style 1. Let me click on OK. And no change. You don't find any change because there is no character which we can see over there. So we'll skip that for this time being. In my next video, I will be explaining that. So we go to the next one, that is entry. So we click on entry and give it CAD style 1. And you can see in the preview box that heading level 1 and entry has changed. Click on OK. So now you can see the change is already applied on this. Right click. Same way, I want to set tab stop. Right now the fill character is dots. Okay, so I'll leave it as dots only. Set the character style as CAD style 1 only. From here you can make changes in the character style which you have already created. So we go to edit, and from here you can go to font, and from here font effects, change the color from here if you want. Like I want to set as pink color, click on OK. Click on OK and you'll see that the text is now, the style overall has changed. It has taken up a pink color because I made changes over there. Again, right click, edit. Some problem was the document closed automatically. Okay, some problem was there with it, so the document got closed, right? So I'm just going to, I'll have to repeat it once again, so please bear with me. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to set the styles at once only. Previously I did it one level at a time, so right now I'm setting the styles all together for all the three. That is also a kind of, I wanted to teach you, so I got this opportunity as my document failed to save earlier. There was a glitch, but OpenOffice and LibreOffice, they come with an internal error handler, so internal document recovery routine. So because of that, your document which was unsaved, it is still recovered. The last autosave version is recovered. So I am giving level 1, level 2 and level 3 subsequently to all of these. Okay, so it is done. We go back to the top. Just click before chapter 1, place the cursor here. Go to index, indexes and tables over here. Right, click on OK and it is inserted. Right click, edit index. We go to entries. And here I'm going to now select tab stop. Okay. First I'll select entry, give it the character style. Okay, now I have to create the character styles all over again. So again, please bear with me. So quickly some character styles I'll create. This red color, and that was character style level 1. Next one, again, I'm going to select some other character. Bold and pink. And this one was level 2. Click on OK. And the third one, that is K. And this one will be, say, purple. So three different character styles. Now we can do our work much easier. Right click on the table of content, go to edit. Make sure entries is selected. Select entry option. Character style you can select from here. Am I not getting that? For some strange reason, these three character styles which I had selected, I'm not getting it over here. Did I get, I set them as, see, I did a mistake. I set these character styles as a paragraph style. So I need to remove it from here. Delete it. Quickly, I'll make this correction. You have to first make sure that character styles is selected from here, okay? So, quickly, I'll do that. This one was character style 1, level 1. Second one was character style level 2. And this one was character style level 3. Three different character styles here. Now we go to our table of content, right click, edit, select entry. Yes, now you can see the three. So first one I have selected, click on OK, and you can see that entry has changed, okay? And I need to change the style, I need to change the color of this also. That is this leader character which you see. These dots are known as leader characters. So right click, edit, they come under tab stop. So I'll select tab stop. From here I can select any character style. I'm selecting character style level 1. Click on OK only, and you can see it also changes the character style of the page numbers. So right click, I'm going to set it for level 2 also. right? And for tab stop also, and for page number also, it is already selected. And here fill character, I'm selecting as single dash. Click on OK. This is how it changes. Then next one, level 3, entry. Select these options, okay? Character style level 3. Go to tab stop. Here I want to give a long dash. And character style as character style 3. Click on OK. And you can see how it changes. Now, because the text was a different type of a font, so we can change the font, because you can see that page number we are not getting, because some fonts are demo fonts. They don't provide us all the characters. So I will change this directly from here. We go to edit. We click on level 3, tab stop. Instead of cats or cat style 3 is selected, we'll go to edit. We'll go to font. And from here, we'll select some other. Like, I will select Adobe Garamond Pro Bold. Click on OK. And now you can see that the text appears. Okay. Save your document for any kind of changes. Right click. Again, go to index. Styles, you don't need to make any changes. We go to columns. From here also, you can set multiple columns. Will appear like this, but it's just kind of cluttered. So again, I'll go to edit, select single column, click on OK, right click. Same way, background you can change. You can change the color, you can change the graphic. Okay, if it is color, then you can simply change. Now, we are not getting any background color options here. So we'll go to graphic, browse. Okay, so again, it's giving me, it keeps on crashing. This is the latest version of OpenOffice, and it keeps on crashing, students. So this is one of the errors. Probably, hopefully, it will be fixed as they get more feedback from various subscribers of it. Okay, so don't worry about it. I had installed the latest version, and latest version always comes with these problems. There are frequent problems, but it has this recovery routine, so that's not an issue. So now we are able, because we had saved it, so we got it back. Okay. Make sure that you keep saving changes to your, saving recent changes to your document, so that you can easily and quickly recover it. Okay. So we were changing the background. Go to background, and now you can see, because it had stopped working, so we weren't getting color. So if you select any color, click on OK, color gets applied. If you don't want color, go to graphic, select browse. And from here also, I can select any background. Like, for example, I select this. I want to give it area. Click on OK, and you can see how it looks like. So this is area. If you don't want area, then you can set it as style. So you can see how it looks like. Okay, so this is how you can make changes in your table of content in Apache OpenOffice Writer. Next is deleting it. Now, how to delete? So right click on your table of content and click on delete index. You have this option over here. The same option is available in LibreOffice also. If you want to remove the table of content, just click on delete index or table. So it goes away. Control Z comes back again, right? So is this clear to everybody how to create the table of contents in Writer, both LibreOffice and OpenOffice? Is it clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Fine. Now, the next thing, the last thing which we are going to learn is, now I have already saved the changes. Okay, so I'm going to close it now, and we are going to do it in Word. We have done it in LibreOffice. We have done it in Apache OpenOffice, and we are left with Word. We saw all this and now we will see it in MS Word. Creating and customizing table of content. So I am going to start Word. Right? And I have this chapter. I'm going to open a new blank document from here and paste the text, the entire text, and I'm going to paste the text as paste special. So look very carefully. We go to this home tab, clipboard group, paste option, and here you find this option, keep text only. Just click on that and only the text gets inserted in your document. Okay, so your text gets inserted. Now what I need to do is again create the hierarchy of headings. So I will select each of these. Now Word is a bit flexible, as you can see. If you place your cursor right before the text here and just click it once, the entire text is selected. Got it? Once you do this, you go to this topmost style area and select heading one. You can change this style of heading one later on. That's not a problem. But right now, what we need to do is just to make the changes. So I'm going to quickly make the change about the author, heading two, coming down. Questions based on text, that will be heading three. So quickly, I'm going to set these as heading one, heading two, and heading three simultaneously. It's not a very difficult task. Once you create everything, you can easily set it. That was the last one. Now I want to go to the top. So there is a shortcut for doing that. Control plus home key. I'm going to share this in the chat box. You can check it. To scroll to the top of the page, control plus home key. So you can just press that control plus home and you will reach the top of the page. Now press enter, click, just insert your cursor before this. And now we are going to insert the table of content. So how are we going to do it? Take a very quick look over here and be and observe carefully. Out of all the tabs, we will go to references tab. References tab, and here you'll find within the table of contents group, table of contents option. So just click on that. Automatic table to manual table. So whichever you want, suppose I want manual table, I click on this. And you can see it automatically enters. Now, manual table means I can make changes in the title here. That is, I myself type the name of the chapter. Now, this will be very cumbersome. Okay. I don't want it. I want to delete it. So for deleting, you already get controls at the top of the table of content. Just click on this and go to remove table of content. It gets removed. Again, go to table of content, automatic table one, and you can see that it automatically creates the table of content. Right? If you don't want this, again, you can click on this, remove table of content. Again, go to table of content. We have this option here, custom table of content. So click on that and you get a dialog box similar to writer. And rest, all of them are disabled right now. Okay, so you don't need to worry about that. This is heading level one, heading two, heading three. Now, if you want to make more changes into it, like if I click on OK here, this whole thing is added to the document. Right? If you click on it, and here also you get these hyperlinks. Control click to follow link. So keep the control key pressed, and you can see this pointer changes to a hand symbol. Click on any of the text and you will reach that text in the document. Got it? Now I want to make changes. So right click on it and you can see the option here, that is edit field. We go to edit field. Okay. Right now we don't get anything over here. So we'll go to again table of contents. Custom table of content. So it will then open your dialog box. We go to options. Don't need to do anything here. We go to modify. Now table of content TOC1. So the first level, this refers to the first level. Go to modify. Properties. Don't make any changes there. Which style type you want to apply, you can select that style type, style based on. So I'm going to click on this drop down arrow and select some style which I had already created. Okay, like my style is there, which I had already created before. Okay, if you want, you can make further changes into it from here. But I'm simply going to click on OK here. Okay, and it will change the style for the first level heading. Replace, okay. So it gets replaced. So you can now see that first level heading style has changed. Let me make some custom styles. So we go to home. And from here, I'm going to select this S. And or I'll go to this option here. Expand this. Applies, create a style. So I'll go to create a style. Name of the style, I'm writing care style level 1. Okay, go to modify. And style type I will select as character. So I've selected the style type as character. And style based on, I'm just going to select default paragraph font, and let us change the font properties from here. Suppose I want a Segoe marker. Font size as 16, okay, bold, italic, and you can see the changes over here. Font color, I'm going to give it red colored font, okay. On okay. So this is character style 1, L1, that is level 1. Again, click on this arrow, create a style. Now next is care style L2, that is level 2. Modify. This is the name. Style type I will set as character style. Okay. Style based on, okay, we can take it as care style 1 and we can make changes. So from here, I'm going to select some other font size, some other font like Adobe Garamond, and let it be only bold, and color I will give it as blue color. Right. Click on OK. And you can see this character, second character style is also created. I'm creating a third character style. This is level 3. Click on modify. Style type, character. Okay. And let me give it some other font. Let it be Arial Black. And let me give it the color as green. So I've given the color as green. Click on OK. And you can see that three different character styles I have created. Now I'll scroll up and go to my table of content. Click it here. OK. I'll go to references, table of content, custom table of content. So I'll change it for each heading level. So right now, heading level 1, first of all, I'll go to modify. For heading level 1, make sure TOC1 is selected. Go to modify. And from here, select the style type first. Okay. Linked character and paragraph. Style based on. So I have to look for the character style which I created. Okay, the thing is, I'm not getting character here. That means I have to set it as a paragraph style only. So students, I am backtracking everything, going back to home. And these three styles I have to delete. I'll have to modify. So right click on them, go to modify, and just set them. And now style type I cannot change from here. So I need to remove them from the style gallery and create three different styles all over again as paragraph styles. So it won't take much time. Again, I'll go to this option, create a style, care, or I'll write here, heading L1, click on modify. I'm going to set it as a paragraph style only, okay? Set it as the Goa marker and let its color be red and no underline and a italics and let it be 14 points, okay? Click on okay. And this is the first one which we created, that is heading level, heading one. Right, let's create another one, heading 2, L2, click on modify, style type paragraph, okay, Adobe Garamond, and let me select the font color as blue, click on okay, and I had my text, I had my cursor placed over here, so it changed. So it doesn't matter, it will change later. Next, I'm going to again go to this option here, go to create a style, heading L3, modify, set it as paragraph, Arial Black, and set it as green color. Click on OK. So three different paragraph styles are created. Now I'll make sure that my cursor stays on this index. I'll go to references, table of content, custom table of content, modify option. Make sure TOC1 is selected for the first level. Go to modify. And now it should display. So let me see. Yes, so it's displaying heading level 1. So I have selected that. Okay, it's not displaying any specifications for heading 1. So I'll make the changes from here. Again, I go to this Segoe marker. If at one place, now we already created that heading. We applied all the features also, but it was not being displayed here. So we need to make the settings once again. Click on OK. So this is it. Click on OK. And you can see heading 1 takes this style. Go to modify. TOC2. This is for heading level 2. Go to modify. And style type based on heading 2. Here, fortunately, we are getting this. So we will click on OK. Now we go to again modify. TOC3. Heading level 3. Go to modify and based on heading 3. Unfortunately, we are getting this one also. Click on OK and click on OK now. Replace this table of content. OK. Now you can see all the heading levels which we had created, all the settings which we applied, they are being applied on the entire table of content. here also automatic updation takes place. Like if I remove this and just write here father, okay, right click on it, update field, update entire table, and you can see it changes. Even it gives you two options. That is, if I make some changes here, like here I'm going to make a change, a dog named Marcus. Okay, I go to the top and here I right click, update field. It gives me two options. Word is updating table of contents. Select one of the following. Update page numbers only. So page numbers means it will not here only the page numbers, because that is most important in a table of content. But if you click on update entire table, then it will update everything, whichever, whatever changes you make in the name of the chapter, the heading, the page number, everything will be updated. Okay, right click. Okay, so we'll again go to table of content and see if there are any more options here. There are no more options as displayed over here, and we don't need to give any background also to this. Okay, so it doesn't take up any background. If you click elsewhere, it just removes that background. Okay, and all these headings are linked. If I keep the control key pressed, your mouse pointer changes into a hand pointer. Click on that and you will reach that particular point within the document from where it starts. From where that particular section or topic starts. Control home, we go to the top. And if you want to delete it, thus just select it, select the whole thing, and press delete button from your keyboard, so the whole thing is deleted. Okay, so this is how you can set table of content. So if you just look closely, you will find all the options are almost similar over here. Okay, the options are almost similar. So we learned how to create a table of content in LibreOffice Writer, in OpenOffice Writer, and in MS Word. Any questions?